Guys, I have a confession to make. I can't fucking read. Hello, internet. This is Olin from What I'm Listening To. As I've been editing these vlogs, I've been noticing that there's been a severe lack of lady musicians. So I've decided that this week's vlog is going to be dedicated to all the ladies. I have a handful of albums here that are all fronted or feature some super, super talented lady musicians, and all of which actually span from all kinds of different genres. There are some good ones here, so let's get started. The first album I have here is Keep On Your Mean Side by a band called The Kills. This band is actually a duo fronted by Allison Mosshart and Jamie Hintz. Came out during the heydays of the garage rock revival scene, so bands like the Black Keys and the White Stripes were all gaining huge, huge notoriety. I've known about this band for quite some time because of the band The Dead Weather. Allison is a lead vocalist on The Dead Weather, and I've been collecting their albums and really liking their work. And I've known that she's been in The Kills, but they are a pretty established band that have a couple of albums out that I never really knew where to start. But I have to thank Steve the roommate for exposing me to The Kills. A lot of the times when he's showering in the morning, I can hear the music he's playing in the bathroom, and there have been times where the song he's listening to sound really cool and I secretly Shazam it. Steve, if you're watching, just don't judge me. But one of the times he was listening to a Kills song that was off this album, and I really, really dug it, so after I figured out which one it was, I went and I got this one. It's really raw, stripped-down rock with some attitude. And it's not as blues-oriented as the White Stripes or the Black Keys, just very, very straightforward rock music. It's got some mean-sounding lyrics, but Allison's vocals are also super sexy, so you get that contrast. I think Fuck the People and Monkey 23 are my two favorite songs off this one. But the rest of the album is awesome, and this edition I got has a bonus 5 songs. Really, really cool band. I'm gonna probably have to look into more of their discography, but I'll be listening to this one until then. The next album I have here is called Psychic Reader by a band called Bad Bad Hats. I saw this band live, actually, when they were opening for the Front Bottoms. A lot of times I feel like people skip out on the opening bands because they just want to go see the headliner, but I actually really like watching the opening bands because half the time I end up really, really liking them. And this band was definitely no exception to that. They had a really, really modest presence, super cool, down-to-earth guys. They hail from the Twin Cities area of Minnesota, which immediately made me think of The Replacements. And after hearing their song Super America, I was sold on getting this album. Sadly, that song isn't on this record, but I'm still glad I was able to support the band. And I even got to meet the bassist and shake his hand and tell him how awesome I thought they were. Personally, I think they sound a lot better live. And not to say that the stuff off this album is bad, I just thought that their live sound sounds way superior than their studio sound. But nevertheless, it's still very fun and happy sounding indie pop music. I recommend checking them out, they're very, very fun live. The link to their Bandcamp will be in the description. Highly recommend listening to this one. Midway between the end and the start, I cried like a baby, I tore you apart. Midway between. Alright, the next album I have here is Taylor Swift's Red. Now, I know what you're thinking. I show off a lot of obscure and very, very blatantly indie bands on my vlogs, and for me to show off a Taylor Swift album is a little bizarre. But hear me out on this. I really, really dig this album. My friend Stephanie, who is a mega fan of Taylor, actually got me into this particular album. Back when we were 18, 19 years old, we started hanging out a lot. And we would have nights where we were just going out, driving around, hitting up an Olive Garden or something, and we would listen to these songs. It got to the point where I heard them so much that not only did I grow to like them, but I was able to scream sing them along with her. So I can't help but to listen to this album and think back to those nights. They were very, very fun. But also, part of the reason I really like these songs is they are a lot more aggressive sounding than her previous work. Personally, I can't really tolerate her earlier stuff. I mean, I can tolerate it up to a point, but it's just so sugary, sweet, and pretty naive sounding that there comes a point where I just am kind of sick of it. But on this one, she writes about past relationships that went wrong, a lot of negative feelings associated with them. There are times where she actually sounds like Alanis Morissette here, which I really liked. So there's a mixture of sad, angry, bittersweet, even some happy songs in there. And the reason I got this on CD is because I was browsing a thrift store and found it for a mere dollar, still plastic wrapped and everything. And after realizing that I had never actually owned a physical copy of it, I decided, hey, for $1, fuck it, I'll get it. So Stephanie, if you're watching, this one goes out to you. Alright, the next album I have here, this is called Walk With Me by a group called Laura Rain and the Caesars. It's not uncommon for me to buy albums simply because I hear them playing at Amoeba, and this album is a testament to that. They were playing the song High Fidelity Man in the store, and normally this kind of music isn't really something that catches my ear, but the vocals on that song had this echo effect that I thought was really, really cool. That song alone sold this album for me. The band hails from Detroit, and I think they were really trying to revive the soul, funk, R&B sound that came out of the 50s and 60s. So their music is very, very big sounding. It's actually a good album to put on during parties. Really, really rad band, probably a modern vintage band, I guess you could call it, because they have such an old sound. If you're a fan of R&B or funk or soul, you should certainly look into this one. Alright, the next album I have here, this is called Have You In My Wilderness by Julia Holter. I saw Julia perform live when she was opening for Beirut at the Greek Theater in Berkeley. I had no prior knowledge of her, and later on I discovered that she actually has a pretty established following. When researching her back catalog, I saw that she started doing very avant-pop, experimental pop-sounding music. And not experimental in the sense of being noisy or weird for the sake of being weird. I think what she was trying to do was just play with pop music and add very bizarre sort of productions to it to make herself stand out. So there were songs she did where it sounded like she literally took a recorder and walked around outside and made that the background to her song while she sang and played over it. Ultimately, after I heard the song Feel You, which is the first track off this album, I was sold on this one. And I think of all the albums she has out at the moment, this one is definitely the most refined and maybe not nearly as experimental sounding, but it's certainly very artistic and dreamy, and it has some folk influence to it. After listening to this one, I think I'm gonna have to explore her other albums because I really enjoyed the experience on this one. So if you haven't heard this record, I highly recommend checking out Julia's music. She's a very, very interesting listen and does some great, great productions. It's impossible to see. All right, so the last album I have here is by a band called Exploded View, and this is their self-titled album. Much like that Laura Rain album, I discovered this band because Amoeba was playing them in the store. It was really echoey and kind of dark-sounding music, and I was super into it. And when I saw the cover, I think I was sold on it. It was even better when I brought this album up to the clerk, and he even said that it's an awesome album, and he highly endorsed it. I later learned that this is a project fronted by a woman named Annika, who was once actually a political reporter and eventually just went on and made music. The best way I can describe this band's sound is post-punk with dub influence. It's got that dark, gothic-y sound that post-punk is known for, but it's also got that jumpy bass and that psychedelic vibe that dub music typically has. It's a really artsy-sounding album, but it is so, so, so good. I definitely, definitely recommend checking out this group. A link to their Bandcamp will be in the description below. This is a fantastic album, and I love them to death. Okay, internet, that does it for me. Hey, if you have any bands or albums you want me to check out, particularly by any ladies, leave a comment down below, and if I like them, maybe I'll include them in a vlog. But until then, this is Olin from What I'm Listening To, signing out. Goodbye. I just hit my hand on the computer. Ouch.